Canine and the Time Trap.
"What we have here," said the burly Rigelian fleet commander, "is a total impossibility."
"Impossibility is usually something a humanoid mind cannot understand."
"Listen, you mechanical bloodhound. This is a total impossibility. The entire Rigelian 7th Fleet can't just disappear. Apart from anything else, it's against orders. So you do what you're hired to do. Go find me a fleet."
K9 sped off on his mission. Just under the speed of light, K-Nail took off across the deep, starless gulf between the galaxies. Here there was nothing, not even a stray hydrogen atom to use as fuel. And K-9 had plenty of time to consider his mission. On his magnetic pads, he carried a Rigelian battle cruiser, which he would use as bait to attract the mysterious enemy. But first, he had to find the trap. Weeks later, by standard Earth time, K-9 was still on patrol. So far, he'd found nothing. He felt less like a mechanical bloodhound than ever. He knew that the Rigelians were not the first people to lose their fleet. Vanishments, as they were called, had been happening since space travel had first begun. True, there had been a rapid increase in the number of disappearances recently, but as K-9 liked to observe,
"These things happen in space."
He climbed to avoid the gas cloud ahead, and the gas cloud climbed after him. All K-9's sensors went haywire. For a split second, he was taken completely by surprise. Then, as he tried to accelerate out of the cloud, he felt a tremendous gravity drag, as though the battlecruiser had suddenly grown much heavier. There was a sound of crashing, tearing metal, and instantly, K-9 flew up like a cork out of the gas cloud. Apart from one or two small fragments still sticking to K-Nail's magnetic pads, the Rigelian battlecruiser had completely disappeared. K-9 watched the gas cloud grow smaller. Some force was sucking it in, and the Rigelian battlecruiser with it. But where were they going? There were no black holes or antimatter pockets in this sector. If he delayed any longer, the gas cloud would be gone. As the last wisp disappeared, K-9 switched to full boost and drove his small white craft at maximum power into the cloud. Inside, all was red. It was like hanging inside a giant crimson hot air balloon. K-9 checked his sensors. Nothing seemed to be wrong, except that no time had passed since the start of his dive. So that was it. He was in a time trap. As far as he knew, only Time Lords knew how to meddle with time. Far below lay something even more amazing. Rank upon rank of starships and freighters from every corner of the universe. Thousands of craft, from tiny satellites to enormous space stations, were all neatly stacked one above the other in zero-gravity blocks as high as skyscrapers. K-9 cruised between the shining towers of this astonishing metal city. It was an immense museum of space exploration, with craft from every civilization ever to have leapt the stars.
"Welcome to my cosmic junkyard, little metal hound."
The deep voice seemed to come from everywhere at once, echoing around the towers of the starships.
"Do not be afraid."
"Fear has not been built into my circuitry."
"I know. I have met your master."
"Who are you?"
For a moment, there was no answer. And then he felt the controls of the craft being taken over.
"A place has been prepared," said the voice.
Try as he might, K-9 could not regain control of his craft. It was landed for him. When he trundled out with his blaster at the ready, he was met by a giant, awesome figure in a purple cloak that hissed as it swept the floor. The figure's head was completely encased in a red helmet, and red light shone behind the slit in the visor. The figure advanced slowly towards him, dragging one leg.
My name is Omega.
I am K-9. If you come any closer, I shall be forced to dematerialize you.
The gaunt figure laughed.
Yo-hoo! Destroy me, Omega, whom a thousand suns could not harm. Then what will you do? Put me in your flying dog hutch?
The figure drew nearer. K-9 stood his ground, his senses twitching.
Listen, hound. I too was once a Time Lord until I was betrayed.
Omega paused, shaking with anger.
Come, let me show you my kingdom.
As they toured the caverns where Omega's prisoners worked, he told K-9 his story. Once, Omega had been a great engineer. It was he who had created the system that gave the Time Lords time travel.
I harnessed the power of a thousand suns for them. They made me emperor, then plotted to destroy me and marooned me here. They think I am trapped in this crimson bubble of time, but soon I shall have my revenge.
Omega gave the signal for the whole fleet to take off. From the other prisoners, K-9 learned that Omega was launching the whole fleet, 10,000 ships at least, in one huge destructive raid on Gallifrey. Countless would be killed and all the ships destroyed. But nothing mattered to Omega save his revenge. It seemed to K-9 that Omega's plan was perfect. Every single craft was under Omega's control and linked to his master computer. The whole fleet moved towards Gallifrey under cover of a gas cloud, completely hidden from any tracking system. But Omega, in his eagerness for revenge, had forgotten one thing. K-9 was also a computer. K-9 worked frantically to free his craft from Omega's master control system. Gallifrey was in sight when he finally succeeded.
Attack! Destroy!
Roared Omega. K-9 ejected from K-Nel and was picked up by a Rigelian supply vessel. He watched from the bridge as 10,000 starships roared down on Gallifrey. Then he gave the signal. The slim white shape of his beloved K-Nel sped like a torpedo straight for the rocket store of Omega's flagship. K-Nel had been an excellent craft, but it had to be sacrificed to save life. It was right on target. The explosion was colossal, and Omega was seemingly obliterated. After reporting to Gallifrey High Command, K-9 flew back with the Rigelian fleet. A surprise was waiting for him in the spaceport.
We've made a few improvements to your original design, said the Rigelian fleet commander, and now she flies like a bird.
K-9 remained silent.
We would like you to accept K-Nel Mark II with our thanks. What do you think?
Stripes are not improvements.
But it did fly like a bird.